Businessmen always wear ties, we don't. We don't want to be businessmen as such. We like to be punning on that, but parodying it, really, more than just kind of adopting it totally.
And for us, it's a simple style of dress, and we feel totally sort of at home in it, rather, but we wouldn't in a pair of jeans and trainers and a sort of colourful, fashionable shirt. We'd feel totally out of place in that. So we are conservative in dress and slightly conservative in manner, but our art isn't conservative, and that's what we produce and that's what we sell.
These three artists work so closely together that they've adopted an identical image. They've even given themselves a collective name to go with the look, the Grey Organisation.
We're looking for a kind of corporate identity. So we had to choose, you know, just a name like a pop group would choose a name, you know. Grey is because it's a colour which hasn't got any emotional... Yeah, emotional attachments to it. It's like a void, and it doesn't actually say anything itself.
It's not quite black, and it's not quite white. That's why it's the in between. It's on the edge.
And in the dictionary, it has it's got many definitions, and one of them is wise and venerable, and the other one is empty.
And shallow.
So it seems to contain all extremes and mean nothing at the same time. So it's apt for us. But it all goes along with a corporate identity, and we have thrown away our sort of individuality as such, as we're not free artists with a name and working separately. We work together on the paintings.
We also think alike as well. I mean, it's not just the clothing. We all three of us think alike. We agree on quite a lot. We are practically one person.
So he'll be kicking his head, and these two will be kicking him in the head.
No.
No?
The one in the middle is the right way up. These two
are upside down. And what about the background? Green? Yeah, grey. Grey. Freedom, then?
Yeah. That is freedom, yeah.
Definitely. Everyone kicking in the head.
Right.
And you've got the two left legs up.
The Grey Organisation like to trace around each other as the basis for most of their pictures. They also like to work with as much speed and calculation as possible.
We like to experiment. We quite enjoy that.
Let's have more blood.
We like to provoke reactions.
The Grey Organisation seem like the sort who'd revel in provocation, whether it's on the canvas or off it. Last May, they were accused of daubing the prestige art galleries of Cork Street in grey paint. They applaud such action as a statement against the stuffy West End art gallery establishment.
They sell themselves as that we are young contemporary galleries like Nicholas Jacobs or something. But really, they are very conservative because, like, when we did speak to Nicola Jacobs, she said, we rang up and said, hello, we're a group of artists and we'd be interested in having an exhibition at your gallery. And she said, I'm afraid I'm too busy, I'm going shopping. I mean, once we said we hadn't been to art school, they practically put the phone down on us. It's like this old attitude that we're reacting against.
Grey Organisation work has been exhibited in London. However, the three Greys feel that their aggressive approach will be more suited to the fast-moving New York art scene.
We look into New York, where the traditional kind of attitudes in the art world have been rather smashed down in the last, say, 10 years, and where now, literally, paintings as in hung on the wall. The actual paintings can be fashionable for 2 years, a painter can for a couple of years, and then he's finished. And thus, there is a much more rapid turnover, which we are seeking for England.
One way in which the Grey organisation have tried to imitate the hype and commercialism of the New York scene is by joining in various media blitzes. They've designed a T-shirt for the Labour Party's recent youth drive and taken part in a promotional campaign for a new brand of jeans with Page Three girl Samantha Fox.
Nothing against Samantha Fox. I mean, I think she's a great person. But I feel we're offering a lot more. Our canvases are saying a lot more than probably she is. But so therefore, we should be up on the same place as her. We should be gaining as much. I mean, she owns a lot of money. She's gaining a lot. She's doing well. But for some reason, we're meant to still suffer and live in Bow, which we're not about. We're not about suffering. That's old. That's history.
Bow, which is the area we live in. We don't really like it. It's just a stopover point. We don't socialise in Bow and in the area in the evenings, but during the day we do a lot of cycling around. We go around looking for ideas in this area.
It's not East London as people have a nice idea of East London. It's, you know, the grotty East London. We cycle around it, have a look.
We want to get out as quick as possible. We're trying to find a way.
Ultimately, we want to live somewhere where there's more life. There's just no life on the streets of Bow anymore.
I mean, we prefer to live in the city, if anywhere, because of the buzz of the money and all the activity that's going on in the city. And it's just fantastic energy going on down there, we like to observe.
The city is our favourite place in London. Brilliant architecture. The new NatWest Tower is quite tall, very interesting.
It may be a while before the Grey organisation have their own plate glass tower blocking the city. In the meantime, they're stuck in Bow, working away.
That's good. Yeah.
If you're there, I'm great. Shouldn't we finish signing it?
Yeah, let's finish signing. Go on, finish signing.
We must get a stencil made.
Yeah.
That was good. And do you reckon more arrows? Just a few more.
Each canvas completed is a step on the road to success, and transatlantic style art stardom.
So it's very hit and miss, really. It may happen, it may not happen, but we'll carry on. We're quite determined. How to be a millionaire. Tell me.
It isn't a work of art.